This week's episode is all about harvesting. We will answer questions like when is the right time to harvest and what to do in these last weeks of flower. This video does not violate YouTube's community guidelines. I do not participate in the sale of illegal or regulated goods or services. And this video is for educational and entertainment purposes only. Enjoy the video. Hello guys, this is Green Cave. It's the start of week 8. That means harvest is around the corner. She's looking beautiful and the buds are massive. I got a new toy. Look at these beautiful time lapses. The channel is getting more professional by the day. I had to tape off some lights on the camera because when it's recording there are some blue LEDs and I heard stories about it messing up the plant's light cycle, and we definitely don't want that to happen. I mounted it on the side, let the wire through the tent and plugged it in on the outside. I think I'm gonna put the time-lapse camera a bit more at the bottom in the future though. All the leaves are definitely dying right now. It's the last week or the last 1.5 week. Harvest is gonna be soon. But I'm checking these trichomes, those crystal balls on the buds every single day. And they're still not turning amber yet, so it's still not time to harvest. I'm unsure whether to water her, but she's dry and I don't water too close to harvest. This could increase the length of the drying time for the buds. So the only way to guess the harvest time is by looking at the trichomes. They start off being see-through, and when all the trichomes get cloudy, the THC is at the highest percentage and you will get more of a head high. When a few of the trichomes turn amber, there is a bit more of a combined body and head high, and most people look for that. But you can do whatever you want, of course. I want to aim for around 10% amber trichomes to get that nice mix between head and body high. Okay, after sitting here like a dumbass for like a half an hour and still checking out the trichomes, I've looked and looked and looked and gotten close up, used my phone, tried everything, but I'm having a real time. I'm having a really hard time figuring out if the trichomes are cloudy, clear or amber. Right now I think most of them are cloudy and a few are still completely see-through. So that means we probably have to wait like another week and then it's gonna be fine, I think. So I think I'm gonna water her tomorrow. If you're enjoying the video, please be so kind to support the channel by giving a like. Subscribe for more videos like this one. Thanks! We started our flushing last week. This means that we are not giving any nutrients before harvest. We do this to drain all the chemicals from the nutrients out of the buds, so we are left with a nice taste. This technique is highly debatable and I'm just experimenting with this. I'm going to give a tiny drop of pH down though, because we definitely don't want any pH problems in these last weeks. So this thing is still completely messed up and it's not giving the right amounts, so I'm just gonna use the pH down just on feel. But for the next grow, I ordered some pre-mixed pH buffer calibration solutions, so I don't have to mess around with these powders and mix them myself, because that's just, it's just tedious. So for the next grow, we should have a working pH meter again. Make sure to shake the bottle. I didn't clean this properly because I thought we didn't have to water her anymore for this grow. So I'm just gonna use this, yeah. It doesn't matter too much, guys. I'm gonna take a tiny drop. Fletch only like one drop, maybe two. Make sure to stir everything around. I still don't have a spoon. Notice that I only took half a can of water because we are so close to harvest. I don't wanna make these buds too wet because I don't want the drying process to take ages. And make sure to water everything evenly. I've never done it live like this with the phone in my hand. I hope I don't spill too much. As you can see, if I go too fast, the watering tray will overwater and the tent will be wet, and we don't want that, so do it slow and steady. Look how fat and beautiful. I don't know what happened to the color, but that yellow, green and red combination just looks so nice. Another upgrade incoming. I taped these old plugs and apparently it can conflict with a fire insurance if the house ever burns down. So I picked up a big one, which is a lot better. Okay, this thing is definitely making me crazy. It's so hard to look at the trichomes with this thing. And I ordered one of those USB microscopes of AliExpress for like 10 euros. So I'll be waiting for that to arrive, but that takes a while and the plant is probably gonna be harvested by then. I really don't know if she's ready or not. I think most of them are cloudy right now and I think I see some amber ones. But trichomes on the outer leaves are more mature than the ones on like the orange hairs. So you have to look at the ones on the orange hairs, but this thing just makes it incredibly difficult. I think we have like half a week left. I think most of them are cloudy on the hairs right now, but yeah, again, it's just difficult. Last week we had some problems with the smell and you could smell the plant in the hallway. So I got these rubbers to stick on the door. And I hope these keep the smell out until I have a new carbon filter or new fan. So that door strip didn't do anything. I can actually smell the plant all the way up on the second floor. Just a few more weeks and we should be fine. I've been looking at it again and today is the last day of week 8. I think we have like maybe the weekend left or maybe like half a week of week 9 and I think then we are prepared for harvest. We entered week 9 and there isn't really anything to do anymore except look at them trichomes. She's probably dry right now, but I don't want to water her anymore because it's so late. I also don't want to make the same mistake as I did with my last plant, of course. I keep looking every 2 days with the microscope on the buds to see check the trichomes. It's now week 9 and I think we got like half of week 9 left before we can harvest. But one thing worries me a little bit. I started not giving her any nutrients and starting the flood process a while ago. And instead of it being 2 weeks, I think it's now up to 2.5, so I think when we harvest her, it's gonna be 3 weeks without nutrients, which is a little bit too much, and probably affected the growth of these buds a little bit, but we'll never know the difference. She's almost looking like a sunflower. The nitrogen deficiency is really obvious. That's why the leaves are looking so yellow. We don't really care about it in flower though. This is pretty normal at the end of a harvest. I'm finally seeing some amber trichomes on the buds and I think I'm gonna harvest her tomorrow and wet trim her. So tomorrow I'm gonna chop and... Oi. Come back here. So tomorrow I'm gonna trim her and chop her off and it should be a great time and it's gonna be awesome. Hopefully. So this is almost the end of week 9 and we will chop her and prepare her for drying. But you will see all of that in next week's episode. I want to thank everyone for watching the video. I can't wait to show all of you the rest of the drying process. If you like the video, please let me know of course. And subscribe for next week's drying process. You won't ever see my videos on the homepage, so click the notification bell. You know what to do. Thanks. And I will see you all next week.